Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, when the faithful vanish. Help, Lord, for the godly man ceaseth, for the faithful fail from among the children of men. They speak vanity, every one with his neighbor. With flattering lips and a double heart do they speak. For the oppression of the poor, for the sighing of the needy, now I will rise, saith the Lord. I will set him in safety from him that puffeth at him. The words of the Lord are pure words. As silver, try it in a furnace of earth. Purify it 7 times. Thou shalt keep them, O Lord. Thou shalt preserve them from this generation forever. Psalm 12, 1 through 8. Our world today is filled with liars and false flatterers. And there are times when the righteous hardly know who to trust. One of the things that the psalm speaks of is the betrayal that comes through deception. Not all worshippers are the same. This is why Jesus made mention that the Father seeketh such to worship him who would worship him in spirit and in truth. Mary from the New Testament with her alabaster box is an example of the behavior that separates the classes of worshippers from the general to those who are highly devoted to the Lord. David in the psalm is experiencing a moment where it seems that the faithful, the holy, the righteous, the elect are nowhere to be found, and he longs for the true worshippers to show up. Increasingly, the sinful culture of society and the sophisticated culture of the modern-day church is doing its best to squeeze the life out of the holy and devoted worshippers. Here are some questions to consider. What would it be like if all of a sudden all those people who we consider to be holy and godly were to disappear from this earth? What would it be like if we walk into a church and saw only groups of ungodly people? What would it be like if we walk into a house of worship and where you expect to hear the songs of Zion instead? It's replaced with worldly music. That is some idea of what David was trying to express in this psalm. He was looking for the faithful, but the faithful had vanished. God will always have a remnant of the faithful who are devoted to him. Elijah would come 150 years later after David and would face the same difficulty. Because of Ahab and Jezebel, he felt as if he was alone and there was no one that was standing up for the truth of God. There are times when we can have the same mentality and think the faithful have vanished. But God always has someone who's willing to stand up to the challenge and do his will. The devil will do his best to tell the people of God that the real wheat is not wheat. But the truth is, the wheat knows what the wheat really is. Furthermore, they know what the tears are. If you have the Holy Ghost and a commitment to the Lord and his word, it will be very hard for you to be deceived. Here's what the tears look like in these days. They miss church. They love sports and entertainment more than they love God. They don't have a teachable spirit. They don't pay tithes. Their prayer life is dead. They don't worship anymore. They become hateful. They have become rebellious. They don't come to the altar anymore. They say, God knows my heart. I don't have to convince the preacher. If you're going to make it to heaven, then you've got to change. If we ever needed a passion and a hunger for the word of the Lord, it is in these last and closing days. The word can pull you out of the deception the devil throws in your direction. Here we are again in 2020, faced with the trials of the restrictions by the curfew. Many churches are not going to be able to have their night services again. Again, let me ask, was your commitment to God or to a building? God's church is resilient. And we should not allow not being able to be in a physical building stop us from worshiping. In Hebrews 11 and 12, it speaks of the cloud of witnesses. These men and women, when they were not able to go into the house of the Lord and worship, they worship even in caves. Child of God, be not deceived. The enemy wants to get you to a place of frustration. He wants to put you on lockdown so your minds become weary. But let me remind you today that your commitment is not to a building. Your commitment is to the Lord. I know not everybody loves Zoom, but the Lord said to Moses, Moses, what is that in thine hand? The reality is, saints, we've got to use what we've got. Do not be discouraged. Let the devil know, whatever comes, Jesus, I'll go through with you. The thought of the day, no matter how bad things get, God will always have a remnant who will worship him. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.